Now, my next friend, Joe Polito. Not only is he a very good friend of mine, I don't see him that often. We speak to each other quite a bit on the phone. He's from Philly, or was it South Jersey?
Philly.
Philly. Yeah. There you go. Even though, yeah.
Hey.
Okay. And this guy is, you know, I've heard him sing several times, and, you know, the guy is terrific. That's why I have him on my show today. Please, give him a nice hand. I'll let him surprise you. Joe Polito, there you go.
Thank you very much.
Blue Spanish eyes, teardrops are falling from your Spanish eyes. Please, please don't cry. This is just adios and not goodbye. Soon I will return, bringing you all the love your heart can hold. Say you and your Spanish eyes will wait for me. Blue Spanish eyes, prettiest eyes in all of Mexico. Spanish eyes, please smile for me once more before I go. Soon I will return, bringing you all the love your heart can hold. Say you and your Spanish eyes will wait for me. Say you and your Spanish eyes will wait for me. La 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 la. La 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 la.
Hey, hello, Joe. Thank you so much. You were beautiful. You know, Joe and I was where we were in the movie. Actually, you want to know something? Come to think of it. All three of us were in a movie together,
yeah.
And Joe played my kid brother.
Yeah.
Yes.
And
Lady Life.
She played my gulmad.
Absolutely.
And that was the Sicilian Tale.
Yes.
Am I correct?
And it won Best Crime for the New York Independent Film Festival.
Yes, wow. Best Crime Drama, and we had a wonderful time.
It was great. We shot in Philly, right?
Philly, yeah. New Jersey, parts of Pennsylvania, and. You know, that was the first half of the movie was supposed to be Sicily in the early 60s.
Yep.
And Frank Lisi, the director, did a wonderful job of pulling it off. Everybody thought it was Sicily.
It was supposed to be Sicily. Where was it? Long Island?
It was actually, we filmed in New Jersey.
Oh.
I thought it was Sicily.
We filmed on a horse farm
it was in
New
Sicily.
Jersey.
But it looked, actually, it
looked good.
Well, I knew that Frank Lisi didn't have
the
money to bring everybody.
That was in New Jersey, yeah. And that was supposed to be in the 1960s. Of course, later on in the movie.
That's when the car pulls up and you're with your wife and all that stuff.
That's exactly right. And Don Gaetano Verdi wanted to hire me to kill for him.
Yeah.
And to take care of his rivals. And of course, he picked me because I was a Sicilian farmer, and nobody would look at this face and think that I would be a killer. So that was perfect for him.
Yeah, that's right.
Oh, that's pretty nice.
We did it. And of course, Vinny was my older brother. But I'll tell you what, for being my big brother.
You got another mint for me or something?
I yeah.
I know. I'm Vinny, afraid takes it from me. I know where it's going to come from.
Vinny was an incredible person to watch. Of course, I didn't get to work with you because you were in mainly in the current day. And so that was 40 years later. But I used to come on the set and watch you, and it was a pleasure.
They spray painted his hair, right?
Well, that was for the scenes in the 60s. When me and you had a conversation, I called you from Sicily,
yeah. Right.
And you were in New York, and I was asking for your help.
Yeah. You know what they did? It wasn't a rinse, but they made my hair black over here. And at one point, it was so hot, it was just dripping down my face.
Yeah.
And when I went to wipe it, you know, all of a sudden my hands were black. And I thought I touched a chair. I don't know where the hell this color was coming from. And then all of a sudden, the director looked at me like this. He said, that stuff is all over your face. You don't want to put it on.
Yeah. But Vinny, that was one, and I told you this, and that was one of my favorite scenes. That phone call was real deep.
Oh, thank you.
That was a deep phone call. Both of you had a nice monologue there, and it was deep. That was my personal opinion.
That's where I told my brother
that
I missed him, and I loved him, and I wish he was here. Yeah. And
I don't remember. How did I end that?
Yeah, you're in too many freaking movies.
Yeah, that's what it was. Well, actually, you know, you know how it is in movies. I filmed it a few weeks before. The conversation on the phone, and of course, a few weeks later, you did your scene of answering me on the phone. So, but basically, you told me, "Don't worry, kid, I'll take care of everything."
Did I?
Yes.
I did, right?
And you took care of everything in the movie. Yes, your character saved my son.
Yeah,
I even took care of her in the movie too.
Oh yeah, well that's in a different way. Yeah,
I don't mean it that way. I'm just saying, Michael White, we had a nice scene, right?
Yes, we did.
It was believable.
I didn't say nothing wrong.
You just look
people out there, they got dirty minds out there.
Yeah,
you know what I mean, so we're talking. Was I nice to you?
You were very.
Did I do the right thing?
You're wonderful.
Right?
Wonderful.
See that? See, wonderful.
Where did you just sing in Philly recently?
Trying to make me blush.
Actually, I sang today. I had a 1 hour performance earlier this afternoon, and I drove out here. So,
from
Vinny says he wants me, then that's it. Everything gets dropped, and I'm in the car.
Hey. I appreciate that. That's great. Well, you heard what's going to happen for the next show. Now they're going to do an interview on me.
That's fantastic.
You know,
I'm interested in hearing.
You got to give us some questions.
I'm frightened to hear what questions are going to answer.
Well, you've been on set with him, so you know we got some. We could work on this. We could do the phone conversation.
I have some questions for him.
We could get
absolutely.
Well, if you have like one or two now, I'll answer them as long as. here we go.
That's a question you
should ask.
Because
you're not going to be here for that show, but I'll answer it on the show.
Well, here's a question, Vinny. You've been doing this for quite a long time. Whatever made you think that, what age were you when you decided, I want to be an actor?
Mm, good question.
Okay. I think when I was in school. Well, actually, because I used to lie so good that everybody used to believe me. So I thought I was an actor when I was a kid.
See?
Except I wasn't getting paid for it. I was getting smacked.
Yeah.
You know, when I found out, my mother used to beat the hell out of me with a hanger. Teacher, I used to get kicked out of school all the time. But then all of a sudden I said, wait a second, all these other kids are doing, I'm doing something wrong, you know? So I went back in and I just learned how to lie a little bit better, you know? And I was getting away with everything. I said, boy, I'm a good actor. You know, people were really believing me.
Well, if you're gonna lie, you are acting. So basically you...
So that's question one, go ahead.
Yeah, question one. Okay, real quick question two. What was the first film that you actually worked on where you got paid good money? I don't want to know how much.
Okay.
Unless everybody out there does.
It's show business.
The first good film that I worked on where I got paid good money. Well, I would have to say Casino. Mm-hmm. I would have to say Casino, but there was other movies where that.
Absolutely.
I would have to say Casino, but there were other movies where I made almost as much. But Casino was the biggest then.
Right.
It hasn't been the biggest since. Because I've done another one that's coming out pretty soon in March called The Irishman with Christopher Walken's Val Kilmer, Ray Stevenson, Paul Savino, Robert Davi, Vince D'Onofrio. I mean, it goes on and on and on, you know. And I play a very nice part. I play, well, I'm not playing an Irishman, but it's called The Irishman. And it comes out in March, and I don't play a very nice guy in a movie. So for all of you out there that know me or have seen me on television or see my show, remember, when you see the movie, don't believe what you see on that screen. I'm a nice guy. That's all I'm going to tell
you. Well, who's better than you, Vinny?
Who's better than me? Yeah. My baby right there. Nah, she's, who's better than me? Lisa, she travels with her brother. She doesn't have to pay for car fare. God bless you.
Oh, that's great. God bless Fantastic.
You. Okay, so now, you know, we don't have much more time left, but the next show, they're going to be interviewing me, and I just know they're going to put me on the spot.
You're in trouble.
I know, with that finger, I can tell. I'll take another candy after. Meantime, I want to thank Richard for coming on my show earlier. Joe, I want to thank Lady Life. I want to take Tank.
Tank, you could take it too. Mm-hmm. Take it away.
That mint did something to me. please,
Old secrets, no lies.
You know, you do so much, you start to get burnt out a little bit. And all of Richard's movie 301 and Gone a Little Overboard and Evil Plots on a Rooftop. I mean, I want to thank my beautiful audience. And you know what? I never thanked all those people up there. Please, thank you so much.
And Maria.
Thank you. Now they rarely know I'm crazy because there's nobody up there. Everybody just looked. It's okay. You know, but it looks like it's a much bigger place. You know, like the Jay Leno show. They got people up
Bravo.
There. Yeah. Oh, how you doing? All right. Thank you so much. The show's over. Thank you so much.